Greetings to all. I am Vinod Taide, lecturer in electronics, Government Polytechnic, Nasik, Maharashtra, India. Today, I am here to demonstrate how to run a program of ascending order for microcontroller 8051 using the MIDE tool. The program is in the assembly language. In this program, we have to arrange 5 number in ascending order. For that, we will open this MIDE tool. From file menu, we will take a new file, and on this new editor, we will write our program for the ascending order. Now we already have the program for ascending order, so we will take its copy and we will paste it in the editor to save our time. So after writing this program, first thing is save as, give some name and with extension .asm. It will save your program. It will show some color coding to your program. These are the comments which are in the gray color. So your program is ready to execute. So as per the logic, what we have to do, we have to arrange 5 numbers in ascending order. That's why we have taken R0 at 04, which is an iteration counter. We will require 4 iterations because we have to arrange 5 numbers in ascending order. Then initialization of DPTR, as we are using the external memory, we are taking the starting address of the numbers into the DPTR. Then we have to put a comparison counter also, which is in the reducing fashion. So I am simply moving the value of R0 into the R1 to initialize the comparison counter. For the first iteration, it will be 4. Then it will be 3, 2 and 1 for the remaining iterations. Then to exchange the number, there is one arrangement. I am just holding the value of DPL into the R2, which we have to use later on. So initially I will take first number into the accumulator. I will move that number into the B register. Then I will increment DPTR and I will take second number into the accumulator. So at this point, I have 2 numbers, one in accumulator and second in the B register. Then I will perform the comparison of A and B. If both are not equal, we will go to this label, not equal. Then we will check whether carry is equal to 0 or not. If there is no carry, then A is already greater than B. We will skip for the next number. And if there is a carry, we will exchange the number which is at 100 and at 101. This is the logic to exchange the number, which you already know. After that, decrement the R1. Which is a comparison counter, and if it is not 0, go back and take the next number for the comparison. So when your DJNZ, this R1 back, when it is R1 is equal to 0, then you will come to the next instruction, which is for the iteration counter. When your first iteration is complete, you will decrement the R0, and if it is not 0, then again you will start from the this instruction, move DPTR 100 to start the second iteration. So logic you already know. Now the task is we have to run this program. So after saving, first check whether any error is exists. So build current file, there is no any error. After that, build and sim, it will open the emulator, make it full screen. Then from the mode, first change your mode to 8051. As we are using the external memory, so find out the memory locations 100 to 104. So in external memory, this is our number 100, address 100. So here we will store our number, as we have to arrange in ascending order. So I'm just simply storing the number in descending order. So at 100, take the 5, then 4 at 101, then 03 at 102, then 02 at 103, 01 at 10. So now I have my 5 numbers in the external memory, correct? And we will run this program step by step, and we will observe the effect how it arranges the number in ascending order. So as per this logic, R0 is equal to 04. Step by step we have to run. So R0, it is equal to 4, which is our counter, iteration counter. Then move DPTR 100. So DPTR is 100 now. Move R1 comma 00. R1 will have same value of R0 because the 4 comparisons we have to do. Then move the value of DPL to R2. In R2, we have value of DPTR, which is already 0. So no effect here. Take the first number in accumulator. See, in accumulator, we have first number. Move this number into the B register. So in B register, you get the 05. Then increment DPTR. DPTR is 101. Take the number which is at 101 to the accumulator. So up to this point, we have first two numbers in A and B. Perform the comparison now. So CJNE A comma B. So after execution of this instruction, we have to observe this PSW, whether we get the carry or not. Yes, carry is there, correct? Carry is there. It means we have to exchange these numbers, correct? So jump if no carry to 0101C. If no carry, then you have to jump. Where? To skip. But this time we have the carry. So simply we will go to the next loop where we will exchange these two numbers. So first take the value from R2 to DPL. So your DPL will become 100. Now move the value of A to add the DPTR. So here you have to observe now. See, now this become 4. The value of A at the 100. Now increment the DPTR. So DPTR is 101. Take the value from B to A. And now observe here. See, now we got the 5 here. So it exchanged the first two numbers, 4 and 5. As first comparison is complete, we will decrement R1 by 1. So your R1 is 03. Again, you will come back. Again, you will store the value of DPL. In R2, it is 01 now. Take the next number in accumulator. Move it to the B. Then increment DPTR. It is 102. Correct? See, at the end, we have next two numbers, 3 and 5, in A and B. Perform the comparison. If not equal, check the carry. Carry is 1. So again, you have to exchange. So again, you can observe here. It will exchange this 5 and 3. Just observe. Now 3 is here and 5 is here. So 3 and 5 exchange. Again, R1 decrement. It is 02. Come back. Store DPL. Again, take next two numbers. Now we have next two numbers, 2 and 5 here. Again, compare. Again, check carry. Yes, carry is there. Again, exchange. Now observe this 5 and 2. It will exchange. 5, 2 here and 5 here. R1 is equal to 01. Again, go back. Store DPL. Take the next two numbers. So next two number 1 and 5. Again, compare. Again, carry. exchange. See, it will exchange 1 and 5 now. See, up to this point, our first iteration is complete. So after first iteration, we have the largest number at the last location. Now, first time we will decrement our iteration counter because first iteration is complete. So this R0, which was 04, it will get decremented now. See, it is now 03. And we are back to the initial position where we have to load the DPTR 100. Why? Because already our DPTR is at the last position. So again, initialize it to the 100. Now again, update the comparison counter. It should be now 03. Because in second iteration, we require 3 comparisons. So again, run this. Take the next 2 numbers in A and B. A and B, we have 3 and 4. Compare, check carry is there, then exchange. So again, observe here, this 4 and 3, it will get exchanged. 3 at 100 and 4 at 4. Comparison complete. Come back, take next 2 numbers for comparison. Next 2 number comparison, again carry, again exchange. See, it will exchange 2 and 4. Again, you will come back, it will exchange 1 and 4. Correct? At this point, your second iteration is complete. Now you will enter into the third iteration. Before that, decrement the iteration counter. Iteration counter is 02. Again, to the initial position, DPTR is 100. Take the next 2 numbers, 2 and 3. Again, compare. Again, check the carry. Again, exchange. Now it will exchange 3 and 2. See. Decrement. Again, take next 2 numbers. Again, exchange. See. At this point, your third iteration is complete. We have 2, 1, 3, 4, 5. Now we will decrement the iteration counter again. It is 0, 1. And now we are in the fourth iteration. So in fourth iteration, we will compare the numbers and we will exchange the numbers. See, at this point, our fourth iteration is complete. So comparison counter is also 0 and iteration counter is also 0 and we are out of this loop. And when you will come out of this loop, you will find that your numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which was initially 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, they are in ascending order. Where we found? At the initial positions only. Initially, they were at 100, 104, and now they are also at the same position, 100 to 104. So this is how we can arrange the number in ascending order. If you want to convert this program into the descending order, then only you have to make a small change. Instead of this JC instruction, you have to use, instead of this JNC, you have to use the JC instruction. If I change this to the JC, again save, again build, again run, open the emulator, find our numbers or the address, external address, store 5 numbers this time. I am taking the random numbers. We have to arrange in descending order. Correct? Five random numbers here. We have to arrange in descending order. Same logic, only one instruction change. So just you have to observe here. I am running step by step. Will not explain anything. You have to just observe these locations, how it changes. So step by step, I am running this. So it will compare first 2 numbers. Already if it is in ascending, it will not exchange. It will exchange. We have to, it is a descending order, so it will exchange. It will compare 1 and 3, it will exchange. It will compare 1 and 9, it will exchange. It will compare 1 and 4, it will exchange. So at this point, first iteration is complete. Now again 6 and 3, it will exchange. No need to exchange because 6 is already greater. 9, 3, it will exchange. 3, 4, it will exchange. At this point, second iteration is complete. Now again, 9, 6, it will exchange. 6, 4, no need to exchange. Third iteration complete. And now the last. Again, no need to exchange. Complete. You can see your numbers in descending order. 9, 6, 4, 3, 1. So this is how we can use assembly language program to arrange number in ascending order as well as in descending order. The same logic you can use for the numbers. If the count or total number are greater than 5, this is for the total number of 5. If you have to arrange 10 numbers in ascending order, simply you have to change the iteration and comparison counters. So that's it from my side. Thank you.